Good morning, everyone. My name is Karis Vucek, and this is our first in the Pepper Six Pack podcast series. Say that 15 times fast for a vocal exercise. We're starting our series very proudly today with Connor Dean Johnston, who is our composer. He did the original score. Connor?
Thanks so much for having me, Karis. Yeah, glad to be here virtually.
Thank you for joining. I know it's a beautiful day here in New York. I'm hoping that everyone is enjoying some good weather finally. And we also have Katie Brow, who is our awesome sound engineer for the podcast series. We're happy to have her with us too.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
So the purpose of these is to introduce the team and have everyone who's been following the series and of course contributing and been such a great support to learn a little bit more about the individual aspects of production and artistic and creative team, as well as technical aspects of putting the series together. Particularly this episode, Pepper Ricochet, is one where we had an original score. And Connor is our composer. So we're just going to talk about a few things and let Connor tell us about what he does. And I'll start out by saying, and also wanted to say to everyone who's listening, thank you so much again for all your support and your just unyielding fandom. We really appreciate it. And we're doing everything we can to keep the story moving. So Connor, just a few things. Just, you know, tell us a little bit about yourself and where you're from.
Yeah. I was born and raised in, you know, small town in central Massachusetts. So middle of the woods, middle of nowhere, but a great place to grow up. But, you know, so I went to school in high school in that area. Then I moved to Boston, went to Berklee College of Music. So that's when I, you know, really started getting into film composing. You know, I've been playing music my whole life. I'd always been in bands. I got involved in playing saxophone when I was a young kid. And it was always, you know, very, very important part of my life. And when it gets time and you're in high school to start thinking about what you want to actually pursue for a career, I circled around a lot of things, but I just, at the end of the day, couldn't really think of doing anything that wasn't music related. You know, that was really the only thing that pushed me and really spoke to me. So that's what I wanted to pursue. So I moved to Boston, went to Berklee, studied film composing. And yeah, here we are.
And it was a four-year program?
Yeah, it was. It was a four-year degree program. You know, there's a whole number of different music-related things you can study, but it was kind of just deciding, you know, how I wanted to pursue music and in what direction. And of course, how you can consistently get some work, you know, in a music related field, because being a performer, you know, it can be so crazy and unpredictable. And at least with film composing, you kind of get such a good balance of the creative side, but also you do have more of a steady income of, you know, gigs and opportunities. It's a little bit of more of a tangible way of, you know, actually getting work writing music.
Wow. Okay. That's good. I wouldn't have thought of that. I mean, we're artists all kind of out there getting our work where we can. So it's good to know that, you know, there's some options in this field that you may have a little bit more consistency. So in your time, with where you've been working, what are some of the highlights you would say of what you've been, career things that you've enjoyed doing?
Yeah. You know, this has certainly been one of them.
Yay!
It's been great. Yeah, it's, you know, I've worked on a lot of short films, and it is really kind of fun joining up with people who are also just kind of getting their start out doing this. And really, you know, there's not always a lot of money involved, but there's always a lot of, you know, passion involved in it. So everybody's always on the same page in these kind of projects where everybody wants to bring the best possible work they can to the table, because it's going to be so representative of what comes next. And that's really exciting for me, just working on those smaller projects, because everybody always wants the best out of everyone, and everybody's also learning so much as they go. There's something really satisfying about, you know, everything finally coming together, and everybody's really worked hard without, you know, really being concerned about how much money they might be making. It's all about just actually getting the best possible product possible.
That's true. That, I mean, that's exactly why a lot of us do this indie stuff. There's not a lot of bang for your buck return on the investment initially. We hope that, you know, things kind of down the road. But I know for me, it's been great to collaborate with you, and we'll get into a little bit more of your approach to that in a bit. But it is about the collaboration and about, you know, feeling excited about coming together, having a team a vision and effort and goal in mind, and then being able to reach that as we have. So when you start to approach composing and looking at what you need to do, can you talk to us just a little bit about what that process is like?
Yeah. Anytime you get, you know, a piece of, you know, film that you're going to be writing music to, I really like to watch it, you know, 3-10 times over without even thinking about music, just to really try to understand not just the plot, but the characters, the underlying themes, just trying to really understand the film and the intentions of the film as much as possible before I even think about, you know, a musical note, because that's going to, you know, all of that is going to inform the direction of the music. And then you start picking apart little scenes here and there. If it's something that needs to be very thematic, you know, you want to think about the themes first and foremost, you know, that are either attached to a character or a place in the film. Otherwise, you just sort of take it a scene at a time and just break it down and start sketching ideas into, you know, into that scene and slowly developing that. It's definitely a gradual process, and it's always good to have sort of a back and forth with the director or producer. When you write a little bit of something, you send it, you know, just to make sure you're on the right track. You get notes on that, and then you fix things. That the whole revision process is huge. You know, you want to be really tight with the director and creator every step of the way, just so, you know, you're not all of a sudden writing, you know, 10 minutes of music and it turns out you want to go in a completely different direction. So
right. Gradual. And that's true. And that's what I will say to everyone. My experience working with Connor was so fantastic, because we had a great dialogue from the beginning. He presented, initially I saw some of his work that's on his website, and was drawn to a few elements and style and, you know, types of music that he could create. So I knew he was right for the project. And then when we started working on something, he had a really great ability to make adjustments and fine tune or you know, take a note, as we say many times. And that was really great as we moved along, because I certainly had a vision of what I wanted some things conveyed in the music. When we shot, I know that I was leaving room for music to come in. Did I know exactly what it was going to be? No, I just knew that it had to be there. And Connor was so fantastic in using his imagination and creativity and filling that for us. You know, one thing I wanted to ask you about is when you said theme. So how do you, when you watch something, you said you start to think of theme. Can you tell us a little bit more about that? Like, what kind of process is that for you?
Yeah, certainly. I mean, so much of that is, you know, tied into like character's intention, the overall, you know, emotional basis of that, you know, whether it's a character is really battling inner issues, or it's could just be a very, you know, romantic sort of film where they're, so really you want to tie into the emotion and create music that just hits that emotion very closely. And if you add a thematic element to it, you know, where it's, there's a very clear defined melody sort of attached to that character, that you can always bring back, and it always ties into, you know, this character's inner thoughts or emotions. You know, sometimes you can have a film where, you know, a character's not really saying anything, but the music can inform how they're feeling and, you know, what's going through their head, even if it's not being spelled out for you. And it's really just balancing, you know, being subtle, but also informing at the same time. And the, you know, theme wise, it's really important to tie everything together, make it all very cohesive.
That's great. And when everyone is able to see Ricochet and then another chapter that we have after that, I think you'll be able to recognize some themes that Connor was, you know, so able to establish for us, which are really, it's fun to see them come up again, and then you understand a little bit more about the whole palette of the music. So that's great. What you know, off question again, and then we'll get back to Ricochet. But what do you enjoy most about your craft?
Yeah, I mean, it's a big question. But a lot of it is just, you know, being able to create something that is being used as part of a larger project. You know, I like writing music just for myself, too. You know, it's fun. It's fulfilling. But when you actually create something and you've really been working with other people every step of the way, and then we finally get to that finished product, and it's something that you made that's a part of this much larger whole, this much larger film, it's extremely satisfying, you know, being able to contribute in that sort of environment. You know, I write music in all sorts of different styles, but the film music stuff is really the most satisfying for me, just because of that team effort.
That's great to hear too. In your work that you've been doing, what are you most proud of? Is there something that you feel you excel at, or that you feel the best about currently right now with your career?
Yeah, I feel really good about my versatility as a composer. I feel like there's just a lot of, you know, different genres, different styles, different ways I can go about writing music that, you know, one project can be completely different from the next. You know, every composer is going to have their sort of, you know, way of writing, their kind of voice that gets into every project. But I like to, you know, just be as versatile as possible, really be able to take on any new challenge. And I think I've really, been able to progress in that sense recently. And that's what I'm definitely most proud of right now, the versatility.
Cool. In terms of working on Ricochet, what were some of the challenges or exciting things? Or, I mean, I know you've covered some of them, but, you know, anything else to add to that? This project, was it different than any others? Or,
well, this project is interesting because it is part of a larger series. You know, it is one episode, and you're dealing with, you know, a shorter film. So you have to really balance where the music is going to go and where there shouldn't be music in something like this. In a larger film, it's easier to kind of pick out and place where music goes. But when you're sort of condensing the length, then, you know, it's really just every single scene is very important, is really meaning something. Really deciding where the music has to go is one of the bigger challenges out of the whole thing, just because it can sound completely strange if there's just music for no reason. It can sound really strange if there's, you know, been music the entire time, then all of a sudden there's nothing underneath. Just finding that balance is huge. And I think that's one of the tougher things with a shorter film or an episode.
Right. And we had two separate locations. So there was, for me anyway, a different vibe between one location and another location, but then having to marry the two to make it cohesive somehow, right, to tell the story. So that was that, you know, for me to be able to try to give you some sort of direction on that and for you to run with it, but really use your own creativity and imagination with it was great. So
tying the flashback to the current time, you know, being able to really blend that together without, you know, interfering or getting in the way was is tough, but it was, I think we really got there.
Yeah. And then of course, we're also working with sound design too, elements of what, the sound designer is doing for, wind and water and other sort of, you know, sound effects, and having the music, complement that and augment that. That was something that I thought, he handled really well too. So that was really great. So how do you, moving forward, what do you see yourself doing? What would you like to be doing more of, besides more of Pepper, of course?
of course, yeah.
What do you see yourself doing? Dream goals, things you'd like to, you know, do, accomplish?
Yeah, you know, I'd love to just get involved with more, more television side of things, because I feel like that's always really consistent sort of way of, you know, being able to write music and really getting invested in a story, if using a more episodic, episodic film. I've also really wanted to try writing some music for video games, because I think that video game music has just gotten so exciting, so interesting, that it's really a great platform to get extremely creative with. So that's always something I wanted to, you know, mess around with a little bit too.
Wow, that's awesome.
Yeah, hopefully get a, you know, a good feature film under my belt soon.
That's the
next step there for sure.
Well, fingers crossed. You certainly have the talent and the creativity to do so. We, our team, myself, I were so fortunate to have you working on Ricochet and Confidential, and look forward to more. And once again, congratulations on your Di Seriale Best Original Score nomination. It's really a great achievement.
Thank you. Yes. I really appreciate it. It's been great working with everybody on the team. Yeah, I'm really thrilled with the results we got. It's been awesome.
Great. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thanks.
Thanks, Karis.
All right. See you soon. You too. Okay. Thank you.